think we're done. Are we ready to give some closings? Is there anything else?
Nothing further from us, John.
Good.
Nothing.
All right. I'll hear closings. If you only if you wish. Not necessary. I'm real clear on what we've got. You can contemplate it for a minute. You want to close? It's okay.
I'm very brief thoughts, Your Honor. Since we were the, I guess we were named the petitioners in the section.
Yes.
I'm going to go last.
All right. Mr. Alvarez? Keep it brief if you don't mind.
Your Honor, the court records, the docket, the case summary has exhibited P28 and P29. The evidence submitted in the testimony of the administrator, his attorney, my testimony, and the testimony of Mr. Craig Jones, shows the court that the administrator was appointed with the consent of the heirs. I filed a claim for reimbursement of my father's funeral expenses. Mrs. Kingery filed an objection. She filed a claim to be reimbursed for expenses that she had paid to the from the state of my mother. I filed an objection. On March 27, 2014, the administrator sends a letter to both parties saying, this is what I'm going to do. I propose to do this. And that's exhibit Fredy to Your Honor. This is how I would pay the claims. This is how I propose to resolve the year's claims. The only claims of the state, because there was nothing else. Fredy Alvarez produces what is requested from him, and that is a signature card within 10 days as indicated in the letter. Mrs. Kingery claims that for expenses, A, B, C, D, all the stuff that she had claimed, are disallowed by the administrator. He says, no, I'm not going to pay those. Mrs. Kingery's other claims, and I call them X, Y, Z, the administrator says, if you produce proof, I will pay it. You got 10 days to prove it as well. I submitted the signature card promptly within those 10 days. Mrs. Kingery did not. In the meantime, Your Honor, the administrator assigned to each heir, at their request, and the request of the attorneys, a claim for battery, undue influence, conversion of funds, alleged by each one against each other. The cases go to the state court. There are complaints and counterclaims in the state court. The state court of Fulton County, a ton of discovery was filed. Back and forward, the case lasted a long time. On August 18, 2014, the parties represented by competent lawyers, very competent lawyers, with the state court judge, Judge Eady, mediating the dispute, agreed to settle. And that would be Freddie's exhibit one. They agreed to settle, and they agreed to settle the state court case and the probate court case. Their objections that they had to the administrator's proposal. They say, okay, we're going to let the administrator do whatever the administrator wants to do. Mr. Craig Jones testified here in the police court that that was settled as well. And that is paragraph F1, paragraph one of that settlement agreement. So that paragraph run and says the plaintiff and the defendant should share equally the proceeds of the state property contained within the state of Federico Alvarez and Graciela Alvarez. We agree that 50-50 less any expenses awarded by the administrator. It's in fact in the affidavit submitted by Mr. Craig Jones and his testimony, he says that he acknowledged from his client
that he was in disagreement with the administrator regarding the way the administrator was paying the expenses. That was resolved there. We said in that agreement, and we knew what the administrator intended to do with those claims. That's the letter previously sent that Freddy's to propose how he was going to do it, was going to resolve everything. So in that settlement, we agreed. Now, within a few days of reaching that agreement, Your Honor, settling that, getting that document, Freddy won, I sent a objection. I filed an objection with this court, telling this court, I object for the administrator to resign from the case. And this is why I don't want the administrator to resign. Previously, the administrator had filed a petition to resign. He says he had too much work. And I said, I object for the administrator to resign. That's part of the record. And I argue that the motion, on that motion, that the heirs have settled their objection to each other's claim for expenses, and that we have decided how we were going to divide the corpus of the estate, that the heirs will abide by your decision on how you will apportion the expenses. See Friday 2. You are familiar with the estate, and you have all the files, the records, you know what this case is all about. A new administrator is going to be costly for the state, more expenses. All you have to do is a final tax report, file the returns, the publications, and do the things that you are obligated by statute to do in order to settle the state. The heirs have consented. And what the administrator had to do after August 2014 when we submitted that document, Your Honor, is what he would have to do when he gets the final order from this court. Nothing else. Your Honor, in 2014, the estate should have been closed. That's it. What did not happen was that Mrs. Kingery, on August 18, 2014, when she walked out of that courtroom, she changed her mind. She didn't want that settlement to be a settlement. She didn't want to recognize it. And as Mr. Spears testified, everything exploded. Everything exploded. I refer, Your Honor, to exhibits P28 and P29, which are the case summaries from both states here regarding the activity that occurred from that point forward. There were pleading after pleading filed by Mrs. Kingery, bogus and frivolous, motions, response to motions, response to the response to the motion, and discovery requests when there was no need to file discovery because the discovery period had ended and the discovery had been taken place already by her competent lawyers. And that would be Mr. Caldwell and Mr. Miser. Email after email to the administrator, and he needed to respond. Filing costs of the state. The administrative costs of the state. The administrator had to charge the state for doing his function. The attorney for the administrator had to do the same thing, had to bill the state, and bring in new claims. She even wrote a new claim as a secondary DESON, D-E-S-O-N, indicating that she should have been paid for her own administrations, as indicated in the last exhibit that the court produced and the administrator submitted to the court, where she proclaimed to be an administrator, an executor, and that she needed to be paid by the state. She refused to produce proof of the claims that she had been requested. And demanded payment, as Mr. Hamburg testified, for her time and the copy in producing what he was asking to produce in order to satisfy those claims that he had decided that he would pay to her. Causing the administrator to file and attend a hearing on the motion for declaratory judgment. And not producing the documents until the day prior to the hearing, as he said, as Mr. Spears testified. She just fought it all the way, causing the state expenses and transits and expenses. Objecting to the administrator's proposal on distribution of the expenses as previously agreed. And waiting until the hearing, the very same day of the hearing, to dismiss her petition for the new claim as a secretary disorder. She has, Your Honor, boycotted her attendance to the closing of the house. The sale of the house, practically the only asset that the state has, after having signed voluntarily with her attorney next to her, being represented by a competent lawyer, a sales contract. She agreed to sell the house. And Your Honor, and that is Exhibits PA, which is the contract, and P9, the emails, and P10, the letter from the administrator. She refused to attend the closing, and she made threat to the administrator unless I am paid for my claims, I will not go to the closing. So the administrator had to dedicate time in writing a letter, emails, going back and forth and saying, if you don't attend, the state's gonna be sued for a specific performance by a buyer, and Mr. Alvarez will be sued too, and you will be sued as well. Well, that cost the state hundreds of dollars in administration expenses. When she could not get her way, and she had to attend the closing of the property, she said, okay, you're doing this to me? I'm gonna report you, administrator, to the State Bar of Georgia for ethics violation. Your Honor, also, she has tried to influence by intimidating the court because she did not like the outcome of the order granting declaratory judgment on February 10, 2016 by reporting Your Honor to the Commission for Ethics Violation. And I testified before Your Honor, she tried to have me arrested so that I could lose my license to practice law as a result of the conviction of crimes of moral turpitude. Thank God it didn't happen, because there was nothing that I've done. I submitted the all the time dedicated and billed by the administrators dealing with Mrs. Kingery for the refusal to attend the closing of the state's real property, the only asset of the state. And 80%, as I testified, of the billing since August 18, 2014, when we settled the case in the state court, renouncing to the objections and saying whatever the administrator wants to do is fine with us. He already told us in Freddy's Exhibit 2 how he proposes to do. He said the time that he dedicated, the attorney's fee dedicated and billed to this case, as shown in Exhibits P1A and P1B by the administrator's expense report, and Exhibits P25A and P25B, which are Mr. Spears' billing to the state time report. And Your Honor, also including expenses as shown in Exhibits 26A and 26B, expenses incurred by the state, including the tax preparation for the years 2015, it should never have happened, 2016, And now, 2017, filing fees filed by the state, copies, courier fees, and so forth, as Mr. Spear has shown in those reports, and all the filing fees that are paid with the court are shown in the clerk's record and in the summary reports. Since August 2014, should be cast against Ms. Kingery. Over anger, not only against her, but against her portion of the state. As prayed by the administrator in the pleadings, his attorney fees and the prayers of his pleading, his attorney, where he prays that she pays for attorney for his attorney fees, and as I prayed by me in my ear, Fredy Alvarez response to administrator's petition for final settlement of accounts in approval of final distribution plan, Your Honor, we submit the pursuant to OCDA sections 9-11-9-68 and 13-6-11. Ms. Kingery's abuse of this process has been based on frivolous claims, based on positions lacking substantial justification and made in bad faith, with malice or wrongful purposes. Mrs. Kingery's conduct in these proceedings has been in bad faith and has been stubbornly vicious. Her conduct has been outrageous. Her ignorance of naiveness is not an excuse. Neither is a factor in these proceedings. Her pleadings, letters, and emails have been knowingly and well prepared. She has been represented, as I testified, by 8 attorneys, but she testified there are at least 6 attorneys during the course of these disputes. She was well advised. Whether Your Honor accepts Fredy 1 as a settlement of Mrs. Kingery's refusal to abide by his terms and the litigation in 2014 or not, her legal conduct on itself shall make Mrs. Kingery solely responsible for those costs, expenses, administration, and attorney fees that the administrator and I have prayed for, not the states of Federico and Graciela Alvarez. Thank you, Your Honor.
Thank you.
Your Honor, my closing will be a bit more brief than Mr. Alvarez. As the court well knows, states many times are emotional. We've seen some emotions today. They involve people who know each other very well. They know how to push each other's buttons. And when money's involved, sometimes they have motivation to do that, Judge. And this is a situation where Mr. Alvarez wants to point to Ms. Kingery and say, you're the source of all the issues that we have to litigate in this case. And that's just simply not true. That's not what the evidence has been before the court over the course of the last 2 days we've litigated this case. He has maintained to the court, even just now in his closing argument, Your Honor, he's trying to convince this court that somehow more was settled in the state court case than the state court claims. And that's just simply not true. That's not what the document said. Your testimony from the attorney, Mr. Skinner, today. State court claims were settled in the state court. And that didn't come over to the probate court judge. And his assertion was that they did, and somehow that they should cause Ms. Kingery to abandon her creditor claims. It's just not, it's not true. And that's, Your Honor, I would suggest is bad faith, is several litigious. Your Honor, this estate's been up for a long time. And people get impatient in situations like this. You know, Ms. Kingery, she waited a long time to have her creditors claim back. She waited to, you know, more than most people, most lay people would expect that a probate case would ever be needed to end. I know there's extenuating circumstances that the court sees sometimes, but there's really not any of those in this case. I think the only real the only thing that could possibly extend it for a period of time, time to close the estate was if the real estate had sold. The real estate sold in about 5 months or so. Now, Ms. Kingery, she's a lay person. She's worked at some law firms, so she's not a lawyer. And she's not a match for her brother who's been practicing law for many years, probably as long as I have. You know, I've never been acquainted with him before, but he seems to be a nice, accomplished lawyer. But she's not a match for that. It's really cost her in this case. You heard her testimony about the amount of legal fees that she spent in this case, Judge, and it's slightly more than $100,000. And I tell you, Judge, she didn't include the my fees to her, which as of today is approximately $8,000, depending on how much the court would the invitation to pay the court would receive at the end. Your Honor, she has some legitimate issues with the way the estate was administered. Your Honor, you heard from her directly, you heard my cross-examination questions, that there appeared to be an artificial sense of urgency to move the real estate. I understand that the administrator wants to get paid in the case, but there seems to have been issues related to alleged defects in the property that weren't defended by the administrator. And based on the testimony of the administrator of the offers being over $400,000 initially, and then the house set up at $359,000, Your Honor, that's a pretty significant margin that should justify trying to defend the defects in the property. You also heard testimony and you saw the documentary evidence about the issues with the real estate taxes. I think you caught everyone by surprise, although it probably shouldn't have, but it did, that the loss of the homestead exemption for several years is going to cause a retroactive tax bill. No argument about whether that's proper or improper. I think it is, but it did create an issue where the state was short funds to actually pay the real estate taxes. And Your Honor, that created a sense or a communication that was interpreted by Mrs. Canary as there's an impending tax, so oh my gosh, we've got to do something to sell this house. Your Honor, what I expect you to be deciding today is whether or not to accept the final statement of accounts of the administrator in this state. Make a determination about the appropriateness of his fees and his request for additional compensation, and make a determination on how the remaining proceeds of the estate are going to be divided. Judge would ask that you divide the proceeds of the estate, the net estate, 50-50 between two heirs. Your Honor, Ms. Kingery maintains her objection to the fees of the administrator and for his request for additional compensation.
Thank you. Mr. Spears?
Thank you, Your Honor. I'm going to address a few more things in the pod. I'll try to be very brief. I know you take good notes. It's a couple of counseling things to begin. I understood Alvarez to say that the administrator had requested a disposition that there was some skewing of the fees and cost of fees towards the system. That is not in there. If I misunderstood you, Mr. Alvarez, I apologize. That is not in the petition for final settlement or the petition for extra time. That is not something that the administrator has requested. What Your Honor does with that is up to you. There might be a question as to what was P30 about? P30 was the verified complaint in state court, which is dated about 14 months before
any petition in this court was ever made to appoint Mrs. Kingery as an administrator of the state, and in fact, she was never appointed as an administrator or personal representative of the state. The appropriate code section defining personal representative includes administrator, executor, administrator, with will and next. And that was the point of Exhibit 30. It was verified through the sworn statement to be something that she was not and had not been appointed by the court. With respect to the real estate value, I think Mr. Hamburg testified a lot about the problems that existed that were discovered as I went along. One of those references, including a structural reference, is included in, I guess, in the final sales contract, which is number 8. Talks about you have to move the house to fix the structure. This, towards the end, was a letter from letter, and that was the basis for extending some of the due diligence claims. In fact, Your Honor, I have looked and looked and looked, and I cannot find any reference to any complaint about the sales price in any pleading filed in this court until April 8th, 2016, which is, I think, later, 2 years after the contract was signed, the listing was signed, the contract was done, and the closing was held. There have been complaints about my client, but the fact of the matter is, maybe it's a problem when you represent yourself, but there has been no petition filed to remove him. There has been no petition for accounting and settlement. You're entitled to know what's going on, and you don't know what's going on fast enough. The simple solution to the court is file one of those petitions, and neither were both, and neither one was filed. So, Your Honor, Mr. Walter Hamburg was appointed as administrator of these estates because the parties and their lawyers couldn't get anything done. He took over, he stepped into this case, and he stepped into litigation between a brother and a sister. You see, make it a field of ceiling of how that feels. But the litigation had been going on for several years, openly, before he came into this case, and it continued after his appointment. He acted appropriately to move this estate forward. He dealt with signed claims. He sold the car. He donated the car and distributed the property. He had the title examined. He had the income taxes checked to see about these people filing. The house was appraised. The house was listed and sold. And this estate is ready to be closed. And we filed a petition for declaratory judgment that cleaned out all the other things. All that's remaining is to give him, or I ask initially, that clear path to close this estate that needs to be closed. Unfortunately, we haven't been able to do that without litigation in each instance. I think you've got notes about what my fees requested are, what Mr. Amberg's fees are, and the fee structure compensation. The one thing that I would ask is that you consider increasing the requested reserve from $3,500 per estate to $10,000 per